Welcome to the iHub. This is the innovation hub in Nairobi, Kenya. As you see, it is an open space for technologists, entrepreneurs, venture capitalists, and business people to congregate. And so this is the open area. It's typically like this during the day, but we can change it up and facilitate talks. Up here, we have a Raspberry Pi shop. So for those who want to buy a Raspberry Pi, they can buy one here. And when you need a break, you can get on the foosball table. And there's typically a foosball tournament that keeps running every couple of weeks. And there's a chill out spot out there where people can relax and also work from a more relaxed couch area.
My name is Erik Hersman. I'm one of the co-founders of Ushahidi with Juliana. We also built the iHub where we're sitting in Nairobi, Nairobi's innovation hub. This is where the investors come. This is where the startups are. This is where the media come to find their stories about who's building what. And it's really just like this melting pot of all the right people and the right things around technology in the country. And specifically the city of Nairobi, which is where most of it's at. And it's the place where we, as our job, we found out later after we built it, is really just to engineer the serendipity that's needed to make sure that people come together and good things happen.
We have three levels of membership: white, green, and red. White members are typically your virtual, if you like, members, people in the larger community, both in Kenya and actually some of them are outside of Kenya. The fourth floor is where the iHub started. It's the community space. It's the tech coffee shop. It's where serendipity happens, if you like. And if you think of the third floor, which is where the mobile incubator is, at the M-Lab East Africa.
This is the mobile lab, or M-Lab, in East Africa, the first of its kind. And this is a consortium partnership, including the iHub. And it's a space for mobile app developers who grow out of the iHub and need specific offices and more structure around their startups, they have more space here.
We really think of what we do here very organically as filling the gaps in the market that nobody else is doing, right? So it started off with the community space on the fourth floor, just like getting people working together and finding the kind of interactions that made sense. There's the community on the fourth floor, there's business really on the third floor, there's research on the second floor, and then on the first floor is where companies that are more independent sit. That's where Ushahidi, that's where Brick opened their office up.
This is Ushahidi. It's the office for the Kenya team, although Ushahidi is quite global. This is where you have the engineering team making the brick. Our designer sits there, the software team sits over there, some of the hardware team and testing sits right over here, and we have our RF engineer who typically works on circuits on that wall over there. And this is the brick right here.
Kenya is a really interesting microcosm of what could happen across the continent. What we had for a period of 5 or 7 years possibly was this really interesting combination of people in government, high levels of government, who actually cared about the infrastructure and the ecosystem developing. While we also had private companies coming in and seeing it as a real viable opportunity, therefore creating demand for individuals at the university level to think about tech as a real business. So all these things happen at the same time. There's a report that just came out 2 days ago, and it showcased that Africa, in all of Africa, every country, Kenya by far has the lowest cost to get online, and also some of the best speeds at the same time. And there's no reason why that can't be replicated elsewhere. It's about government focusing on what it's good at. Two things: infrastructure and policy.
It's been an incredible journey for the past 5 years here at the iHub. We started out without a floor. It was just concrete with an internet connection. And even during that time when there was no floor, there were people here with fantastic flow, and there's one of the organizations that came out of it is Akira Chicks. They now have their own space downstairs, and it's a group of women who run outreach and training programs for underprivileged women to teach them how to code. But they also go to high schools and teach, share the tech story, so that when kids grow up and get out of high school, they can look at a career in technology as an option. That's something that some of us, there was nobody coming to school to talk to us about. We never had that opportunity. So I think that is one really amazing success because it opens up the door for others.
So this idea that the iHub could be its own platform for more amazing people and more inclusivity was a really big part of our decision to help build it.